Hi students, I am Professor Aves Ahmed Hussaini, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at SIT COE Yadrao. In previous video, in lecture number 2, we discussed the points related with the fire tube boiler along with their construction and working. But in this lecture number 3, unit number 2, we discussed the water tube boiler along with their classification and construction and working. So let us start with the definition of that water tube boiler. So what is exactly that water tube boiler is? So students, first of all, keep in mind that the main specialty of that water tube boiler is generally it is mostly used for a high pressure application. More than 100 bar capacity pressure we can use that water tube boiler. So the definition of the water tube boiler is here. You can see that the shell as well as the furnace area, tubular area. So here you will get clear idea about the water tube boiler. So students, in case of the water tube boiler, the water is continuously flowing through the tube and the rest of the area is surrounded by the fire. So this is nothing but the water tube boiler. I repeat once again. In case of the water tube boiler, the water is continuously circulated through the tubes and it gets surrounded by the fire. So it is called as water tube boiler. So these are the some important characteristics of the water tube boiler. Few of them are listed here. The forced, induced and balanced draft help to improve the combustion efficiency. So this is the main specialty. So again, the list. Tolerant of the quality of the water produced from the water treatment plant, so that water must be conditioned on the mineral. So here we maintain the pH level, that is the most important thing. The third is allow the higher level of the heat efficiency. The next is, we already discussed that the efficiency of the water tube boiler is around 90%, but whereas in case of the fire tube boiler, it is in between that 60 to 75%. The next is the boiler is used for the needs of the very high steam pressure, such as used in case of the steam power plant. So in case of the all NTPC, the water tube boiler is mainly preferred. The steam capacity in between 4500 to 12,000 kg per hour with very high pressure. Next is using oil and gas fuel for the boiler, water tubes assembled from the refractory. So the next is using solid fuel for the boiler, water tubes that are not assembled at the factory. So these are the some important characteristics of the water tube boiler. So let us start with the basic parts of the water tube boiler. The first is that steam and water drum. You can say it as a shell. It is about the 8 meter in length and 2 meter in diameter. It is made by some kind of the stainless steel material which is corrosion resistance. The next is that water tubes, that tubes are also made by corrosion resistance materials. Sometimes MS are also used, sometimes stainless steels are also used. The angle is in between that 10 to 15 degree, these are inclined sometimes. Then the uptake and downtake headers are there in order to circulate that water continuously in the drum. Then the next is grate. Grate is a passage in which actual that fuel like coal is getting burned. Then the furnace is the area about the grate where combustion of that fuel takes place and hot gases or fumes are produced. The baffle is the fire brick baffles are there. The two are, it is near about 2 in number, are provided to deflect the hot flue gases for separation purpose. The next is superheater. The boiler is fitted with the superheater tubes, which is placed just under the drum and above the water tubes. The main function of that superheater is to increase the temperature as well as the pressure of the steam generated through that particular boiler. So these are the some important basic parts of all water tube boilers. So students, let us start with the discussion of Babcock and Wilcox boiler. So it is a high capacity boiler. Generally, this particular boiler is mostly used in all thermal power plant where the pressure is more than 100 bar. Here you get idea about there is one cylindrical shell Here we stored the steam. Also, it consists of the n number of the tubes through which water is continuously flowing. So this is the main specialty of that Babcock and Wilcox boiler. The tubes are around inclined in between 10 to 15 degree. So here, in case of that Babcock and Wilcox boiler, the water is continuously flowing through the tubes, and the rest portion is get surrounded by fire. So this is the main specialty of Babcock and Wilcox boiler. So again, these tubes are connected with two upper head as well as that datum head. You can say it as downtake head and uptake head. It will help to connect that particular drum to tubes. So continuously water gets circulated in this way. Also, here there is one furnace is there. Through that furnace, combustion of the fuel takes place, and whatever the flue gases is there, it gets surrounded to that tube, and here due to that radiation effect, the water get heated and it continuously circulated through that tubes and drum to reach the maximum pressure. That circulation process is carried out till we will get that high pressure, and this is a continuous process. Again, we will require n number of the mountings as well as accessories to work that particular Babcock and Wilcox boiler satisfactory. So here, n number of the safety valves, fusible plug, then pressure gauge, water level indicator is required. Also, safety valve is required for safety point of view, as well as we need that economizer, superheater, then air preheater in order to improve the efficiency of that thermal power plant. So this is all about construction and working of the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. It is very simple in construction. Again, it is a one kind of this horizontal cylindrical shell. It is connected by n number of the tubes through downtake and uptake headers. It is an area through which the water is continuously circulated in that particular portion, and the rest portion is get surrounded by fire. And these are the n number of the bricks are used. So this is the construction and working of Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Friends, the second important water tube boiler is a Stirling boiler. So here you will get idea about the construction. Here you will get the total three drum, the first, second and third. It consists of the two upper drums, and one is drum is located at the bottom. So that bottom drum is supposed to be that water or that mud drum, and the first two drums is related with that steam drum. Keep in mind that. So there are total three. The first upper two are related with the steam, and lower is related with that water or that mud drum. The steam drum are connected to the mud drum by banks of the bent tubes. These are shown here in the figure. The steam and water space of the steam drum are interconnected with the each other so that the balance of the water and the steam may be obtained. So this is the most important thing of that Stirling boiler. Students, in case of that steam drum 1, here you will get idea about that baffle plate. It is mostly used for that separation purpose. The feed water from the economizer is delivered to the steam drum 1, which is fitted with the baffle. The baffle deflects the water to move downward in the drum. The water flows from the drum 1 to the mud drum through the rearmost water tubes at the backside. So the mud particle and other impurities will move to the mud drum, where these particles may be deposited. As the drum is not subjected to high temperature, so the impurities may not cause harm to the drum. The blow off cork blows off the impurities. So this is the main specialty of that Stirling boiler. Also, the most important thing is this particular Stirling boiler is generally used for 60 bar pressure capacity, and streaming capacity is approximately 50,000 kg per hour. So this particular boiler consists of n number of the mountings, like So pressure gauge, safety valves, water level indicator, pressure gauges, fusible plug. Also, the most important thing is it also consists of the n number of the accessories like economizer, superheater, air preheater, etc. Also, n number of the pumps are used. So the main function of that particular baffle is to restrict that particular portion. So here in these particular tubes, the water is continuously flowing and circulating, and the rest portion is covered by the flue gases. So this is the main specialty of that Stirling boiler. This is another type of the water tube boiler. The name of that particular boiler is D-type boiler. Generally, it is mainly used in case of the sugar factories, also in case of the process as well as food processing industry. Such kind of the water tube boiler are used. The pressure capacity is in the range of more than 40 bar up to 60 bar. Such kind of the D-type boiler is used. The name indicates given is that the it look like that D shape. So the name is given as a D-type boiler. It consists of the five important components. The first is convection, water valves, tubes. These are the tubes. In that tube, the water is continuously circulating, and the rest portion gets surrounded by the fire. So this is again the water tube boiler. The second is that steam drum. Here it is situated at the top side. Then the third is the water drum. It is at the bottom side. Then the fourth is the passage. It is known as the furnace. It consists of the grate and that combustion area where actual combustion of the fuel like bagasse as well as the coal is carried out, and tremendous amount of the flue gases are generated and they get subjected to the tubes, and because of that radiation effect, the water present inside that tube get heated and that water get converted into steam. So this particular process is continuously going on till maximum amount of steam is produced in the steam drum. So this is a very simple construction as well as working of that D type of the boiler. I repeat once again, it consists of the important components like tubes. It is connected to the both drum, that is steam drum as well as that water drum. Steam drum is situated at the top, water drum is situated at the bottom. Continuously circulation is there naturally, also sometimes forced fully with the help of the pump, water is continuously flowing, but most of the cases because of the density, the water is naturally circulated through this particular drum. Also, it consists of the furnace where actual combustion of the fuel takes place. And the fifth one is that water valves tubes. These are the supplementary tubes. So with the help of that radiation effect, the flue gases get come in contact with that tubes. That tubes are made by some kind of the stainless steel or MS material. It is joined through the welding process to the tubes. And precaution is to be carried out regarding that leakage. So here this particular type of the boiler is mostly used to convert that steam into water into steam in case of the application like sugar factories, processing industries, food industries, etc. So as far as advantages are to be considered, the advantages are the operation of the that water tube boiler is very easy and safe. Then the next important is efficiency is very high, up to 90%. Small steam drum is required. Flue gases, that is in water tube boiler, the flue gas flows vertically. So it is very easy to escape out that gases through the chimney. So less power is required for the draught application. Then the space required is very less as compared with the fire. And as far as that disadvantages is to be concerned, the water tube damage is there because of the continuous circulation of the water, so they get chances of the corrosion. So the material selection is the most important thing here. Then the next is water level. The water tube boiler, in case of the water tube boiler, uses less water, and for this reason the water level need to check randomly. Every time we have to check it for that safety purpose. So this is again a disadvantage. Then the next is that maintenance cost is very high as compared with that fire tube boiler. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of the water tube boiler.